Good morning. Today we are going to discuss basic disk and dynamic disk. When you are working with a hard disk drive, it can be either a basic disk or a dynamic disk. Let's have a look at the features of basic disk and its limitations. When you install operating system on a hard disk drive, by default, it is a basic disk. Basic disk is one of the oldest storage models, and right now it is still continued. And this basic disk can support partitions only. That is, you can create partitions or you can create volumes on a hard disk drive. But with a basic disk, you can create only partitions, and the partition related information is stored on a table called partition table. What kind of information is stored? It stores like what is the size of partition, what is the type of partition, and what is the start and end address, its file formats, etc. And where you will find this partition table? This partition table is stored at a place called MBR, that is the master boot record. So master boot record stores the partition table, and this MBR is stored at the beginning of the hard disk drive, that is the sector one of your hard disk drive, first sector of your hard disk drive. And you can cannot create partitions with multiple hard disk drive. That is, if you are having two hard disk drive installed in it, you cannot combine the spaces of two hard disk drive using basic disk. The partitions you can create on a hard disk, basic disk, it must be of same hard disk drive. Okay, so we will have a look on it. Graphically we will explain it so that you can have clear picture of it. So one of the limitations of this one is the first limitation, that you cannot combine space. If you want to have a large partition size, it is not possible with this one. Second is that it cannot be extended. You cannot extend the any partition. Okay, so this is the second major limitation. What is the advantage of it? Is that it can support multi-boot operating system. Say you can have two operating system installed in your PC. Say you can have Windows XP and your server installed on the same PC, and you can switch between the operating system, or you can have XP and Linux installed on your PC. This is possible with basic disk. Now let's have a look at the various types of partition it can support. Three types of partition it can support. First one is the primary partition, second is extended partition, and third one is the logical disk within the extended partition. So the primary partition is the partition which holds the operating system, that is the partition in which you can store the operating system files or the bootable files. And you can have maximum of four primary DOS or primary partitions on a basic disk. So if you want to have six partitions, so you cannot create six primary DOS partitions. Okay, so what method you should follow? You can have three primary partitions, and the rest of the space can be assigned to extended partition. And within extended partition, you can have as many as possible logical disk. Or other method is that you can declare the first drive as a primary partition, and the remaining space can be assigned as extended partition. And within extended partition, you can create some lots of logical disk drives. So be careful, logical drives can be created only within this extended trust partition. So this is the key information that you can have maximum of 4 primary partitions only on a primary or a basic test. So let's have a look on the graphical view of the basic test. You can go to this place using computer management. Right click on my computers, and then you will have computer management option, and then go to disk management. So you will have this. As you can see, there are 2 hard disk drives installed here. One is disk 0 and disk 1. You can see that here it is mentioned that it is a basic test. This again is a basic test. Now see the legend. This one is primary partition. Next is extended partition. This one is free space, that is right now not assigned to any partition. And last one is logical drive. Let's have a look. In the first hard disk drive, we have created a primary partition of almost 10 GB. And the remaining space, that entire space, is assigned to extended partition. This one. And within extended, what we have done, we have created one logical drive. And still there is some free space, almost 11 GB is free. We can create another or more than one logical drive here. And the second hard drive contains one primary partition, and remaining space is assigned to extended partition, and within extended one logical drive is created. So this is an overview of various types of partitions. Here you can see we cannot mix up this space of disk 0 and disk 1 and create a single partition. This is one of the key limitations of basic disk. And other limitation is that you cannot extend it. This is a hard partition which holds the operating system, and right now it is almost full. You wish to increase the size, it is using some free space on the same hard disk or other hard disk, it is not supported by basic disk. This is the key limitations of your basic disk. Let's come on to the dynamic disk. By default it is basic, so before you continue you need to convert this to dynamic disk. So you will see later that how we can convert it to dynamic disk. First thing is that instead of having a partition table, it supports LDM, that is logical disk management database, to store partition related information. It is a newer version of disk type supported by a hard disk drive, and instead of partitions it supports volumes. And this is because of this LDM, that is local disk manager. And it also allows you to create volume with free space from multiple hard drives. That is, you can create a volume by combining space from 2 hard drives also, or 3 hard drives also, or 4 hard drives also. So this is the key advantage of using volumes. This is the first most important advantage. Okay. Next, it allows you to create large volumes. This point is just extended here, as we can create volumes with free space from one more hard drives. So almost the extension of this one. So this is all. This is because of this LDM. Sorry, this is misspelled. This LDM. It's logical disk manager. We can extend volume using free space from same or other hard drive. This is the next key advantage of a dynamic disk. You can extend a dynamic disk by using free space of same hard drive, or you can add a new hard drive to your PC and you can extend the volume size. This is the second main advantage of using a dynamic tube. Other advantage is that there are various types of volumes. One of the volume is having this feature that it will give you faster access to the data stored in it. So if you want to have a faster access to your data, you can pick that volume. We will look at it in the other video. Next is it provides fault tolerance. That is, even if say you have created a volume with space from two different hard drives, if one is now not functional, it will still continue to work. Okay, so that is fault tolerance. Next is, in case of failure of disk, you can recover data from it. And the limitations that you can discuss is that it does not support multi-boot operating system. So the key advantages are, you can create large volumes by adding space from two or more hard drives. Second is, you can extend partition by adding space from same hard disk or other hard disk. And some of the volumes gives you faster access to the data. Some gives you fault tolerance. Some gives you recovery of data. So let's have a look on the various types of volumes you can create on a dynamic disk and what are the requirements. So you can see there are a list of 5 different types of volumes. First one is simple volume. To have a simple volume, first you need to have a dynamic disk. And how many dynamic disks are required? Only one. So a simple volume is something which can create a volume with space from only one hard drive. Span volume allows you to create volume with two hard drives. So minimum you need to have a two hard drive dynamic disk. So it must be dynamic disk. Striped again is same requirement as span volume. You can have two dynamic disks. And it is also known as RAID. We will talk about it in the next video. That is a redundant array of independent disks. It represents RAID 0. Okay. And this gives you fault tolerance and other kind of things. Mirrored volume, you again need to have two dynamic disks. It is referred as RAID 1. Third one, last one is the RAID 5. And for this you need to have 3 dynamic disks. This one gives you fault tolerance. Okay, and this one is also used for storing data at two places, so you can recover data if data is lost. One drive is damaged, you can still have access to the data. Let's now see how to convert it. Just right click on the basic disk and convert to dynamic disk. It will show you a list of all hard drives right now connected to your PC. This year, just check both the boxes, click OK. It will show you the listing that will be converted. Just click on convert. After conversion, you have to restart your PC and then you can see that now it is, both of them are dynamic. And this you can achieve without any loss of data. So you can see here there are two volumes. Each one is having, and this one is simple volume. It is created using space on same disk. Thank you for now. We will continue with features of various volumes in the next video.